Today, my distinguished guest is the world's most valued artificial intelligence company, SenseTime's president of International Business Group, Mr. George Huang. Mr. George, it's an honor to host you here, and welcome to Soft Talks, first of all.
Thank you. It's my pleasure. Thank you. Thank you for the invitation.
I know you are a very busy man, and that's why I will directly jump into the questions. As you know, we are working for a while, and I know you and about SenseTime very well, but could you please introduce yourself a little bit and tell us what SenseTime does as a company and also your role in the company?
First of all, thank you very much for the invite. And I'm the president of international business that basically bears full responsibility for all the international business. And obviously, Middle East and Europe, Turkey is one of our key markets. SenseTime is a leading global AI company that uses computer vision and deep learning. And that's some of the advantages, main advantages we have, and that help us to empower AI applications across many different industries, such as city management, healthcare, entertainment, and education. Those are just some of the examples.
Okay, thank you very much for the introduction. We all know that artificial intelligence field in China is nationally supported and highly invested area. Also, the Chinese government has a national strategy to become the world leader by in AI by 2030. And in my opinion, they are already leading the world right now. And also, as a result of that, there are so many Chinese companies founded to work on this field, and the competition is very fierce. As SenseTime, what do you do to make a difference from other companies in the field of AI?
Yeah, that's a very good question. So I think one of the key differences is our DNA of the company. SenseTime was born with a very AI DNA and technology DNA inside R&D DNA, let's put it this way. So when the year 2014, when we start the company. And that's back then was the first time around the world that computer recognition accuracy surpasses human eyes. And that's something that was initially developed by our R&D engineers in SenseTime. And that's the year SenseTime officially started. So you could see back then we had a good DNA inside of the SenseTime. Since then, our focus is always on high R&D talents. And we know that the talents are the most critical thing in the field of technology, especially for in the area of AI. And that's as has been continued that kind of a focus and core values inside of our SenseTime. And when you that delivers lots of advantage and results that consequently give us good results. For example, we own our self-developed deep learning platform, which allows our clients to handle many different complex AI scenarios. That's very important. That's our own proprietary deep learning platform. And also, when you look at our R&D across the world, we spend 50% of our resources are in the R&D area. And that's a very different from most of the AI companies around the world.
That's great. So basically, DNA, core values, and R&D investment makes you ahead of this competition. Thank you. According to your predictions, what's the future in the artificial intelligence?
That's a big question. So obviously, you could, as I said, I mean, most of the things human beings right now making an analysis is through your eyes. As your eyes seeing things or information, then human beings make an analysis and make a determination of results, what you want interpretation is. As we're going forward in AI, and SenseTime's goal is to be a very responsible AI company and develop more sophisticated analytical skills through computer vision. And that means that hopefully what computer sees, obviously it's already seem more accurate than the human eyes. But obviously, everything around the world where a computer can see and interpret those data even more accurately or more better apply to all kinds of fields, especially in the areas of education, healthcare, entertainment. To hopefully we can enable those things to drive the economy, make people's life better and better for tomorrow.
Especially for this year, right? As you know that this year was a tough year for all of us and marked by COVID-19. The business models of all companies have radically changed and we are all trying to adapt, let's say, the new normal. At SenseTime, I know that you are using AI and various technologies to battle against COVID-19. Can you please a little bit talk about your COVID-19 solutions?
Yeah, so obviously this has been a very tough year for everybody. So back in March, when the outbreak of a pandemic, SenseTime right away, a week later, already created a solution. Our R&D engineer, product engineers, that created a contactless thermal screening product that puts into many different buildings, allows people to screen the temperatures. And that was right away developed. And given the in China, obviously, you can see the outbreak in Wuhan and everything, the medical resources was very tight. And so we created an application where we had an application before to use computer vision to diagnose regular lung diseases, normal lung disease, and then we added features, applications to detect also COVID-19 as well. So those are the two things right away we developed, our team developed, and to provide to the, contribute to the relief of COVID-19 efforts. Then as we going forward now around the region, even in the Middle East, it was, there's different applications being asked us to do and to develop. For example, remote education, right? It's one of the things everybody now, like you and I right now doing the Zoom calls, everybody is doing the schooling is also through the remote education. How do you do as many contactless sort of application, AI application being created around the world as we're speaking?
That's great. And also we try to adapt some of these solutions to Turkish market by Softek as your local partner. And speaking of this partnership, and Softek and SenseTime bring their power together and we build up a partnership deal between these two tech companies, especially for Turkish market. May I also get a few comments on this as well?
Absolutely. So first of all, I mean, Softek is one of the leading companies in Turkey, technology company in Turkey. So it is obviously our honor and pleasure to partner with Softek. And I think combining the two companies together to penetrating the market in Turkey, it will be a fantastic opportunity, not only just for SenseTime, hopefully brings a lot of benefits to the end users that we can both provide in Turkey. And we're looking forward to a very fruitful partnership with Softek.
Thank you very much for the comments. We're looking forward to the same. Last but not least, likewise China, AI field is also emerging in Turkey as well. And each year, so many startups establish to get their, let's say, the piece of from this cake. Hey, do you have any suggestions for the startups, especially the artificial intelligence startups in Turkey, who want to progress towards success like SenseTime?
Yeah, so I think when I travel around the world, especially in the region, in Europe and the Middle East, I notice is that there's more and more startups. There's a lot of energy around the region. And last time I was in Istanbul, although it was a quick visit, but I can feel the energy. So that's fantastic. So I think from our experience, my only recommendations are probably three things, right? One, any startup based on our experience from SenseTime, one is you certainly have to have a very clear vision or mission statement for the company. Why you want to do this company is important. So why, when you start a company, are you going to change the world? What type of things you want to do? So that's one, is very important. Secondly is you certainly have to have a good products and talent. I think a talent is absolutely important, especially in the technology world. So you have to have a very, very good talent. And 30, I think you got to be persistent. Obviously, any company, startups, you're going to have up and downs. So you obviously got to be persistent. Look at the long term. When you have a very clear mission statement or vision, so you stay with the long term. Don't let the short term setbacks to affect your positivity or your confidence level of the company. So, and in essence, is looking for certainty from the uncertainties, you know? So it's gotta be that. I think that's the three recommendations that I wanna make to a startup CEO.
These are great recommendations, and I hope in the future we will also have some Turkish startups successful, likewise SenseTime in the world scene. Mr. George, I have so many other questions, but not to exceed our time limit, that's all for now. Thank you so much again for your time and participation to Soft Talks. Hope that our partnership will continue to be fruitful and your business on overseas will be more successful in the future. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much for the time as well. Thank you.